When considering Elon Musk, one of the most immediate associations is his fearless attitude toward failure. Elon Musk is known for his bold approach to innovation, often willing to take risks that involve letting rockets explode in the pursuit of progress. However, there are certain situations where even he draws the line. Take the Dragon capsule. He remains committed to its traditional design, firmly believing that it is the only genuine option available. Introducing Sierra Space, an innovative company based in Louisville. It is truly challenging established notions. Curious about how Sierra Space accomplished what Elon Musk thought was impossible? Let's dive deeper in today's episode of NR Studio. Have you ever considered why NASA chose a winged spacecraft design for the space shuttle, even though it was an orbital craft? A significant factor lies in the vision and expertise of the individuals involved in its development. Many NASA engineers received their training in aeronautics, which led to their perception of spaceflight as a natural progression from atmospheric flight. This perspective led to the tendency to use glide vehicles designed to land on runways like airplanes, rather than descending into water like traditional capsules. This is where the shuttle's ability to navigate across a range becomes significant. The ability to navigate effectively during reentry and land accurately on a runway. However, the narrative goes beyond mere engineering principles. Political and financial pressures also play a role. NASA made the decision to use solid rocket boosters rather than pursue the more advanced liquid rocket option. This choice was driven primarily by cost considerations, as solid boosters were more economical to develop, even though they may not have represented the optimal technical solution. Ultimately, the shuttle was decommissioned after 3 decades of service, not because of operational failure, but because it had become too expensive and fraught with risk to maintain. The tragic Challenger disaster of 1986, along with the Columbia disaster of 2003, highlighted the significant safety issues associated with space missions. The shuttle's design included important features such as wide delta wings and a complex array of thousands of fine heat shield tiles. These elements were originally included to meet requirements set by the Air Force. However, they also contributed to the overall weight, complexity, and maintenance challenges of the system. The challenging experiences faced during the space shuttle era prompted NASA to return to a design that focused on greater reliability and cost efficiency, the capsule. This focus on basic principles has influenced subsequent NASA initiatives, such as the Commercial Crew Program. Organizations such as Boeing and SpaceX have adopted the proven capsule design, which takes significant inspiration from the Apollo Command Module. The capsule features a streamlined design with fewer components, which inherently increases its safety during launch and reentry. In addition, the capsule offers a cost-effective solution in terms of construction and maintenance. This brings us to the Dream Chaser, an innovative spacecraft built by Sierra Space. NASA initially decided against using it for a crewed mission due to the complexity of the system and the fact that it was not properly prepared to carry astronauts at the time. In 2016, NASA revisited the Dream Chaser project, converting it into a cargo delivery vehicle. As part of the Commercial Resupply Services Program, the Dream Chaser has been awarded a contract to transport supplies to the International Space Station, ISS. This mission represents a significant advancement for the innovative winged spacecraft design. Now, the spotlight is on Tenacity, the first cargo-carrying variant of the Dream Chaser. Sierra Space is determined to show that the design can actually live up to its delivery goals, both figuratively and literally. Since its debut, Tenacity has generated significant excitement in the space community, largely due to its striking resemblance to NASA's famed space shuttle, albeit in a sleeker, more streamlined design. A key feature of the Dream Chaser is its incredible versatility. Unlike the original space shuttle, which used solid rocket boosters, SRBs, and its own main engine to achieve a vertical launch with an impressive 7.8 million pounds of thrust, the Dream Chaser takes a different approach. It operates independently of a fixed launch system. It has the ability to be deployed on a variety of different rockets. This adaptability gives Sierra Space a significant competitive advantage. Expanded launch alternatives and contingency strategies are built in if a particular rocket is unavailable. During cargo operations, the Dream Chaser spacecraft folds its wings inward, allowing it to fit into the rocket's payload fairing. Upon entering space, it unfurled its wings and continued its journey. In its upcoming development phase, The Dream Chaser spacecraft will embark on crewed missions without a payload fairing during launch. This is essential to facilitate an in-flight abort system. To put that into context, the Space Shuttle was comparable in length to a DC-9 airliner, measuring about 122 feet or 37.2 meters, with a spacious payload bay measuring 18.3 meters long and 4.6 meters wide. It had the capability to carry a variety of cargo, including satellites and scientific instruments. Supporting the construction of the space station, it was essential to manage and maintain modules specifically designed for this purpose. These payloads could weigh up to 27,500 kilograms, which is equivalent to 60,600 pounds when positioned in low Earth orbit. The Dream Chaser offered a more compact design, measuring just 30 feet, 9 meters long, which is about a quarter of the size of a traditional space shuttle. When combined with Sierra Space's Shooting Star Transfer Vehicle, the system has the capability to transport as much as 5,500 kilograms of pressurized and unpressurized cargo to the International Space Station, ISS. This includes basic necessities such as food, hydration, equipment, and scientific experiments. Upon return to Earth, the craft descends gracefully, making a landing on a runway. The interior space of the space shuttle, excluding the airlock, is 67 cubic meters. Tenacity provides an impressive 33 cubic meters of pressurized space by integrating the spacecraft and its cargo module. The Dream Chaser's compact design enhances its maneuverability and operational sustainability. Furthermore, this smaller size plays a significant role in providing a cushioning effect for fragile payloads during reentry to the runway at 1.5G. One of the major differences between the Dream Chaser and the Space Shuttle is its thermal protection system. The shuttle is equipped with approximately 24,000 heat shield tiles, a number that is 12 times greater than that used on the Tenacity due to its larger dimensions. These tiles are extensively designed, featuring sophisticated curvatures and intricate interfaces that introduce significant complexity and pose considerable maintenance difficulties. NASA has set a bold goal. Only one in every 108 tiles could possibly show failure. However, just inspecting and replacing the tiles between missions requires a significant investment of time and resources. Dream Chaser is equipped with approximately 2,000 special thermal tiles, each carefully designed to protect the spacecraft from the extreme temperatures experienced during reentry, which can reach up to 3,000 degrees Fahrenheit. These innovative tiles ensure that the interior remains cool and comfortable, maintaining a temperature of just 350 degrees Fahrenheit. Sierra Space claims that its tiles are not only stronger, but also lighter than the tiles used during the Space Shuttle era. Each tile measures 10 inches by 10 inches, which is larger than the shuttle's 6-inch by 6-inch tiles. This means fewer tiles are needed, leading to lower overall risk and simplifying the maintenance process. To comply with contemporary safety regulations, the Thermal Protection System, TPS, is required to withstand impacts from micrometeoroids and orbital debris. The Dream Chaser tiles were designed with this goal in mind, ensuring the safety of cargo and future crew throughout the mission. In an effort to improve thermal efficiency while in orbit, Sierra Space has incorporated white tiles alongside conventional black tiles. These white tiles are designed to reflect more of the sun's heat, helping to regulate the temperature inside the craft. In the process of bonding the tiles, Sierra Space uses room temperature vulcanization, RTV, silicone for effective bonding. This material exhibits exceptional performance under high temperature conditions, making it an excellent choice for space missions. However, their efforts do not stop there. Each tile bond undergoes a thorough testing process that uses a tensile mechanism to ensure its durability under stress. Even the slightest misstep can have dire consequences, making this testing a critical element of the quality assurance procedure. This demonstrates Sierra Space's dedication to developing a spacecraft that is not only innovative and efficient, but also prioritizes safety and reliability for future space missions. In a significant step forward, Sierra Space is working with the United States government. Oak Ridge National Laboratory, ORNL, which is part of the Department of Energy, is set to develop an advanced thermal protection system designed for next-generation applications. The innovative heat shield design uses a material derived from silicon carbide, known for its exceptional high temperature resistance and reusability. The tiles are made from a special composite material that has strength comparable to carbon fiber, while offering thermal stability similar to ceramics. This unique combination is what is needed to withstand re-entry temperatures exceeding 3,100 degrees Fahrenheit, 1.704 degrees Celsius, at speeds exceeding Mach 17, or about 13,000 miles per hour. What contributes to this significant advancement? The outer surface of the tiles withstands the extreme temperatures, while the inner layer serves to insulate and protect the rest of the spacecraft, ensuring it remains within a safe and stable temperature range. The increased safety and durability contribute to reduced maintenance requirements, extending the life of the heat shield. Strong winds improve operational efficiency. In contrast, consider the Space Shuttle. Its exterior tiles are projected to last about 5 missions each year. Dream Chaser has introduced an innovative tile design, with the goal of completing a minimum of 15 missions before undergoing significant upgrades. This development will revolutionize the industry, with NASA already partnering with Dream Chaser for resupply missions to the International Space Station. This upgrade aligns with their strategic goals for the future. The new tiles improve commercial payload performance by being lighter and maintaining the spacecraft's aerodynamic design, even after multiple heat exposures. Maintaining a uniform outer mold line is critical to ensuring reusability. According to Greg Larson, principal investigator at ORNL, the aerodynamic structure remains unchanged to ensure the vehicle can achieve its desired flight performance. None of this comes without its challenges. The development of the new system took more than 30 years of dedicated effort from both groups involved. Sierra Space and Oak Ridge National Laboratory, ORNL, are currently in the early stages of their collaboration. The teams intend to obtain a patent on the technology and then rigorously test the tiles in real-world conditions to ensure their feasibility and performance. Upcoming destinations. The next location on the itinerary is NASA's Ames Arc Jet Complex, a unique facility specifically designed to mimic the intense heating that occurs during a hypersonic aircraft's atmospheric entry. Next, the team will focus on reducing production costs by implementing advanced manufacturing methods. This initiative will pave the way for the system's integration into future Dream Chaser models, with the next vehicle being called Reverence. The advancements mark a significant breakthrough in what has traditionally been seen as one of the most challenging aspects of spacecraft construction, the heat shield. Elon Musk has noted that developing a fully reusable thermal shield is one of the most significant engineering challenges in spaceflight. It's not just about heat resistance. It involves material selection, structural integrity, and durability over time. Reusable heat shields are designed to withstand the extreme temperatures of atmospheric reentry, which can reach 7,000 degrees Fahrenheit, far beyond the melting point of most materials. This requires the development of advanced composite materials that can survive multiple missions without cracking, warping, or breaking. Unlike ablative shields that disintegrate upon reentry, reusable thermal protection systems, TPS, are designed to survive multiple missions while maintaining their structural integrity and functionality. This requires the use of materials that can withstand intense thermal cycling without fatigue or compromising their structural integrity. The importance of cost cannot be overstated. If your shield is designed for reuse but requires extensive inspection, repair, or replacement after each flight, it lacks scalability. The Space Shuttle heat shield was notorious for this aspect. The complex design consisted of over 20,000 unique tiles, each requiring ongoing maintenance and attention. Sierra Space leveraged innovative technology to improve safety and cost effectiveness by reducing the number of tiles used and simplifying the inspection process. Finally, we come to the integration factor. The heat shield should not be considered an afterthought. It is critical that the heat shield integrates seamlessly with the spacecraft's aerodynamic configuration, structural frame, and mass distribution. This is especially important for future missions that will venture far beyond Earth orbit. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode.